Ciao ragazzi.
Hi guys, we're back here with B.Beat for another tutorial. Today we are covering a quite specific topic regarding the use of B.Beat, that is, the creation and use of what we have called the shows. Therefore, the shows that we can organize with the B.Beat. As you have seen in the previous tutorial, on B.Beat you can build playlists, but that is not the only way to create a set list of backing tracks. Today we are talking about the opportunity to build shows that, unlike playlists, can contain any type of media. The show can contain a backing track, a video track, even a space of time occupied only by a metronome. In the show, we can add a section where the only thing present is the metronome. Let's see how the show is built so you can better understand the potential of this tool to organize your own schedule, your event, if not your own show in its entire development. With the B.Beat Manager, we can set up the show. The show is made up of many scenes. So the first thing to do is to create a new show and name it, for example, Video Show, and save it. At this point, the software requires to insert a new scene. Click on the plus key and create our new scene.
Premiamo il tasto più e creiamo la nostra nuova scena. Ecco.
As you can see, we can insert an existing scene or create a new scene. In this case, we do not have any type of scene in our archive, so we create a new one. The new scene is automatically inserted into the show. So now we can add the media events to the scene as we like. Double-click on the scene, and here we have a box inside which we can insert the events that build up the scene. With the plus key, we insert an event that in this case could be a backing track among those already stored within B.Beat. A metronome, a portion of time occupied by a metronome, a video or a blank space. We start by adding a backing track. In this case, we select this file and add it. As you can see, this slot indicates what is the element contained within the scene. We add a second element, which could be, for example, a metronome. Here we can choose the BPM 120, the duration 1 minute, and the metric 4/4 in this case. We add the metronome. As you see, between the two elements there is a small slot with two symbols, the stop and the play symbol. In this case, the stop symbol is selected, meaning that as the first event is finished, the backing track, in this case Blue Celeste by Blanco, B.Beat stops and waits for our input, which can be given by keyboard or pedal, to proceed with the second slot. Now we can add the third slot, which will be another backing track. We add it into the scene, so we now have these three events that make up the scene.
questi tre eventi che costituiscono la mia scena.
So we have two backing tracks, a portion of the metronome 120 that lasts 1 minute, and another backing track that will last 3 more minutes. For example, here we want to add the automatic play, so after the second slot, B.Beat will play automatically to the third one. So we could keep setting the scene, as I said, by adding audio files, metronome, media, video or images, or even a blank space. If we want to add 2 minutes of blank space, because we will perform an unplugged song without backing tracks, for example, we could do so. Also, we can edit each slot as we like it. We have set up the scene, which is already saved on B.Beat. So, the show we are creating is made up of this scene. Together with the scene, we can add a media, a video, that will play during the scene. I can add it in this slot below by selecting a video or image. In this case, I choose a random media. It lasts 4 minutes and will be played during the scene. So we will have a music scene with the backing tracks, metronomes, blank spaces during which the band will play, all supported by a video. For example, if I want to create a pre-show where I have a lineup that I can create the same way with audio recordings, that can be MP3s.
Una scaletta che posso configurare in questo stesso modo con delle registrazioni audio che possono essere degli MP3.
Or some ambient music that I want to insert in the pre-show, I will be able to support it with a video that automatically scrolls during the musical performance. So, here we have the first scene. At this point, going back to the show, we see that it is made up of a scene for a total of 10 minutes. Of course, I can add other scenes until the conclusion of my event. This information is directly saved on B.Beat. So, it is ready for the show. All I have to do is unplug it, put it in a briefcase, and take it to the live performance. The show can only be created with the B.Beat manager on the PC, because the only thing that can be done directly from the B.Beat as lineup work is to create the playlist. Given the complexity of a show that can combine different elements, we preferred to limit the editing within the software. So this is how shows are managed. Another thing I want to show you regarding the software updates that are coming out of the B.Beat manager is the possibility to download the MTA files that MLive provides from the Song Service Marketplace. .it/.com/.de, depending on where you are from. We produce backing tracks in multi-track audio format, MTA, that can be used on B.Beat. B.Beat has its own multi-track format, the MTA-8, because as you know, B.Beat plays up to 8 tracks stereo, 16 tracks mono. From the Song Service website on the multi-track area, the website includes many formats, MIDI, MP3, video, etc. Here we can purchase the backing tracks in MTA format, and we download a version made specifically for B.Beat. The first thing to do is being registered on Song Service, meaning create an account. Then it is necessary to log in from the B.Beat Manager. You log in from this page, entering the same email and password registered. From that moment, Song Service recognizes us, so it knows that when we purchase an MTA, we buy them for the B.Beat. So, we will receive the correct format for B.Beat, and they can be played safely with the device. When allowed by the publishers, the MTA also includes the lyrics that can be seen through the prompter app available on tablets or smartphones. If you are a cover band or you play international music and want to build a repertoire of published songs, with the MTA files, you can set up a repertoire which is already complete, including lyrics, when available, that can be seen on the smart device. When the lyrics are not present, it is possible to add them as a meta event within a DAW. On this matter, we will probably expand the features of the B.Beat Manager, adding an edit section for lyrics. A new version of the B.Beat Manager will soon be available that will allow sheet music to be added in PDF format. The music sheets will then be inserted into the audio projects and then projected on the stage via the prompter app. Available free on both Apple iPad and tablet Android. Well, in the next tutorial, we will see some other features of the B.Beat, including the metronome and all the features of system that allow you to customize the device and make it suitable for your use. Bye everyone from M Live.